I could not believe the news I saw coming out of the NFL on Friday afternoon. I'm very rarely surprised in kind of an angry way, but when I saw this, I was legitimately aggravated to start off with. And judging from the reaction on Twitter, I wasn't the only one. The New York Jets signed Joe Flacco, certified bum, to a one-year contract worth $1.5 million. Now, I don't care that Joe Flacco was picked up. Usually, I'm not a fan of teams with young, developing quarterbacks, in this case, Sam Darnold, signing a veteran with a little bit of name value to be the backup. Guys like Sam Darnold haven't cemented themselves as the franchise quarterback yet. It's not like signing Joe Flacco in somewhere like Kansas City, where we all know that Patrick Mahomes isn't losing his starting job anytime soon. Guys like Sam Darnold, Josh Allen in Buffalo, even Jimmy G in San Francisco, who doesn't have the full faith of Kyle Shanahan and John Lynch, these guys aren't standing on solid ground. But I don't feel that's the case with Joe Flacco signing with the Jets. He is not coming in to compete for the starting job. He's coming in to compete for the backup role. There's no chance in hell he takes the starting job from Sam Darnold. I like Sam Darnold. I think he can be good, maybe even great. I always talk about how critical it is for young quarterbacks to be drafted into a good situation. That hasn't been the case for Sam Darnold to start his career. Coaching changes, injuries. Hell, we were talking at one point last season about Adam Gase possibly being fired mid-year. All of that is detrimental to the development of a young quarterback. One of the most important things to their development is stability. And Sam Darnold hasn't had stability so far in New York. Here's what initially pissed me off and had me a little bit aggravated with the Jets signing Joe Flacco. I have talked at length on this channel about Cam Newton. He still, today, remains without a job in the NFL. I've thought the main reason he hasn't been signed yet is because teams are concerned about his health. Due to the COVID pandemic, teams haven't been able to evaluate him. He hasn't been able to take a physical. I mean, it makes sense if you really think about it. Cam Newton has dealt with injuries the past few years. He hasn't been the same quarterback since his MVP season back in 2015. So I get it. I get why teams are a little bit nervous about Cam Newton. But on the other hand, if teams are having trepidation about signing Cam Newton, then how in the hell do the Jets not have that same trepidation about bringing in Joe Flacco? He's recovering from neck surgery. I saw a report Friday that he might not even be able to start practice until September. He failed his physical with the Broncos. He's a turnover machine. Hasn't had a decent year since 2016. Hasn't made the playoffs since 2014. He was atrocious his last 2 years in Baltimore. And don't even get me started with how he looked in Denver last year. He was one of the worst quarterbacks in the league. He was an eyesore to watch. It was like watching a blind man throw the football. So, how in the hell did Joe Flacco get a job before Cam Newton? First of all, Cam Newton to the Jets would be a terrible decision by Adam Gase. Like I mentioned earlier, you don't want to bring in a star quarterback to compete with Sam Darnold. Make no mistake, Cam Newton is still a superstar. Joe Flacco has no chance becoming the starter in New York unless Sam Darnold goes down with an injury. Even then, it's only temporary. Secondly, Joe Flacco is cheap. I think one of the problems with Cam Newton right now is he is wanting decent money. And teams aren't sure if he can play at the level he has in the past. I mean, NFL teams don't make multi-million dollar decisions without being sure that you can take the field and perform. Everyone knows Joe Flacco will never be the same quarterback that he was back in 2012. The dude has been out of his prime for 3-4 years now. I think Cam Newton is wanting a similar deal to what Andy Dalton got from Dallas, when he should be looking for a deal similar to what Jameis Winston signed in New Orleans. He signed with the Saints 1 year, $1.1 million base salary. Of course, he has incentives if he ever gets to take the field. That is the type of deal Cam Newton is looking at, but he just can't accept it. He wants to sign somewhere where he can compete for the starting job, and he wants to be compensated for it. At this point, though, I don't think it's going to happen. I've thought since the beginning, and still believe, that New England is the best and most likely landing spot for Cam Newton. But the longer this goes on, it can either get better or worse for him. If he's not signed by the time training camp starts, one of two things will happen. Teams like New England, Jacksonville, they will see progress from Jarrett Stidham or Gardner Minshew, or they'll realize that these two guys are bum material and they need a veteran like Cam Newton to save the day. I think it's more likely to happen in New England than Jacksonville. I think the Jags are heading into a full rebuild and 2020 is going to be a transition year for them. I see other reports about Cam Newton maybe going to Denver or Washington. I just don't see it happening. I mentioned the Redskins the other day as a potential landing spot for Cam Newton because of the potential reunion with Ron Rivera. But the more I think about it, the less likely I could see it happening. Washington's not in a position to compete for a championship anytime soon. At 30 years old, I think Cam Newton wants to go somewhere that he can contend in the next year or two. The Redskins, honestly, they're just a long way from that. And I don't understand why Ron Rivera brought in Kyle Allen either. The fucking guy was part of the reason that he got fired in Carolina. He was god-awful. I don't understand that decision. As far as Cam Newton and the Broncos are concerned, I don't see it, and I think it would be a mistake. The Broncos are really behind Drew Luck. He looked pretty good towards the end of last season. Denver already has a great defense. There's no need in shaking things up when you have a young quarterback with a lot of potential. Bringing in Cam Newton would just be a distraction. So even though I was initially kind of pissed off at first hearing of the news that Joe Flacco got signed before Cam Newton, when you take a minute to reflect on it, it makes sense. Joe Flacco's not a threat at this point in his career. And Cam Newton doesn't really fit the Jets' offensive system. They're a team with an offense designed for a pocket passer, something that Cam Newton has never been. I think we are reaching a point where the reality is Cam Newton is likely to begin the 2020 season watching from home like the rest of us. Now, that's not to say that he won't get signed somewhere eventually. Things can change quickly in the NFL, especially as the calendar starts nearing September. Guys like Jarrett Stidham, Gardner Bum Minshew, they can look really promising in training camp in the preseason. A 1-3 start to the season can quickly change how a head coach looks at their, quote, promising young quarterback. We all saw how Dwayne Haskins looked last year. It was a disaster. I think he's on a short leash with Ron Rivera. If Haskins gets off to a slow start, do you really think Ron Rivera is going to rely on Kyle Allen again? It was a disaster last year. What makes you think the result would be any different? I don't like Cam Newton going to Washington, but when you're sitting at home making no money, you go where you're needed. I see some sites saying that Joe Flacco getting signed before Cam Newton is a bad look for the NFL. I know that there are race issues in the NFL. We all know that. I'm not going to get into them right here, but what I do know, Flacco getting signed before Cam Newton has nothing to do with Flacco being white and Cam Newton being black. I understand kind of why some people could see it that way, but the reality of it is, Cam Newton's fighting an uphill battle. He is a superstar player whose production has dropped dramatically since 2015, who's battled injuries the past few years, and expects to be paid and step in somewhere to fight for the starting job when there's big question marks surrounding him. No one knows if he will ever be the MVP caliber Cam Newton that we saw in 2015. Some people will say, Joe Flacco is also coming off injuries and his production's dropped the past few years too. Which is true, but Joe Flacco isn't walking in with expectations of being the starter. And everyone knows he's well past his prime. He also won't bring in the media attention that Cam Newton would. He's not going to be a distraction. He's going to be more of a mentor to Sam Darnold. Now, I have no doubt Cam Newton will be starting somewhere at some point in 2020. But instead of thinking that it could happen by training camp, I think we're getting to the point where it'll be closer to the regular season before Cam Newton gets picked up. And I hope it's with New England. All right, that's all for today. Make sure to hit that like and subscribe button for me. Click that notification bell to receive all notifications from the channel. Leave me a comment in the section below. What do you think about Joe Flacco getting signed before Cam Newton? What do you think the reason is? Let me know your thoughts. You can follow me on Twitter at KC_BTL84. If you have any questions, email them to btlkc84@gmail.com. Enjoy your Memorial Day weekend. I will see you guys next time.